Welcome back to the Showboat Hotel and Casino here in Atlantic City. We've got junior middleweights coming up, Alfredo Rojas and Kevin Pompey. Pompey is a very interesting young man, outside of the ring as well as in. And Al Bernstein filed this report about this young fighter.
Kevin Pompey is a solid fighter who has come up just a bit short on two occasions on ESPN. Against Joe Summers, he showed the good body attack that is his trademark. And it was give and take. And Kevin didn't do quite enough to get the win. Against Victor Davis, two wins later, Pompey was looking for a win that would lead to contention. He unleashed his left hook as a major part of his attack and pressured the favored Davis. And he thought he had the win, but instead it was a draw. And now, after a win over Stacy Burris, Kevin tries it again.
That gives you a bit of the flavor of this upcoming bout between Rojas and Pompey. To introduce the fighters to you, let's go to our ring announcer. Here's Michael Buffer.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, this bout is scheduled for 8 rounds, and it's in the junior middleweight division. The referee is Tony Orlando. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, he's wearing the red trunks with white trim and weighs 146 and 3 quarter pounds. He's originally from Maracaibo, Venezuela. Now, living and fighting out of New York City, New York, he brings a professional record of 14-2, 6 KOs. Ladies and gentlemen, Alfredo Rojas. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, he's wearing the gray trunks with red letters and weighs 146 and 3 quarter pounds also. Fighting out of Troy, New York. His professional record, 11-2-1, 6 KOs to his credit. Ladies and gentlemen, Kevin Pompey.
Hi, gentlemen. I want you to listen to my commands and I expect you to obey them. Do you have any questions at this time?
No, sir.
All right, touch gloves, go back to your corner.
We follow Kevin Pompey back to his corner. 146 and three quarters. Actually closer to the welterweight limit than junior middleweight. And there's Alfredo Rojas. He is from fighting out of New York City. Well, that bell has an echo effect to it, doesn't it? Here at the showboat?
Hey, after that fight, I took everything has an echo effect.
These two men are billed as junior middleweights, and in effect, of course, they are, but they're much closer to being welterweights than they are junior middleweights.
And Kevin Pompey, as we saw in that highlight package, he really would, you know, he really needs a win here to show that he is a skilled guy who could get into contention. He's not a bad fighter at all. I mean, he's got lots of skills, but he's getting a win column on television.
You know, fighters are very interesting people. More so out of the ring, perhaps, Al, than in. And in talking to him this morning, he was KO'd by Warren Nelson in Atlantic City, knocked out in the sixth round. That was the last round of that fight. With about 20 seconds to go, Nelson caught him, and Pompey was frank to admit to me this morning that he was stupid. He made a very dumb mistake, and Nelson hit him, and he deserved to get knocked out. In the fight with Victor Davis, whom we saw here a couple weeks ago against Terrence Ali, Pompey was complimentary of Davis. He said, boy, what a tough guy he is. Every time you think you've got him, why, you find out you don't have him. And Ali found that out in the eighth round. It was the best round Davis had. Then he had the unfortunate headbutt and the cut, and they had to stop the fight. Pompey's interesting from another standpoint, too. We discussed the movie Rain Man, the Academy Award-winning performance by Dustin Hoffman. He works with autistic adults. He's a very interesting young man, this kid in the gray trunks, Kevin Pompey. And he said he couldn't believe what a job Hoffman did. He said because the things Hoffman did, he sees every day of his life. He didn't believe anybody, not autistic, could be able to do that. Yeah.
Good indication of we get so many boxers that do something else in addition to boxing. And it runs the gamut. Right now, Pompey is getting his left hook in, which is important for him. He's got a terrific left hook, the body and the head. Rojas is feeling that left hook.
Rojas is in the trunks that bear his name, Rojas, right? And we've got the gray trunks and, of course, Kevin Pompey in there. And round one is been busy, and both fighters very active here.
Yeah, very good first round.
Indeed.
Pompey probably getting the better of it, but Rojas landing his share also.
Pompey working with an uppercut. haircut to his advantage in there, as both fighters are very, very close. Less than half a minute to go here in round one. Rojas has Pompey against the ropes. Tony Orlando is the third man in the ring, and round one. Scheduled for eight, coming to a close. Rojas very busy as the round comes to an end. We'll be back to see about round two after this.
The Kevin Pompey left hook, it worked in the first round. Here's an example of it. Oof. Good leverage on that punch. Got his whole body into it. Textbook left hook.
All right, we're back to live action. This is round two, scheduled for eight. We're at the Showboat Hotel and Casino in Atlantic City. That's Rojas in the red trunks, Kevin Pompey in the gray. Pompey fractured a bone in his hand back in January, his last appearance in the ring. Well, there you see how many punches were thrown. Rojas very, very busy. Pompey, waste not, want not. He was very, very effective with the 45 punches he threw, and down goes Pompey.
From a jab.
Oh, yeah, nailed him.
Wow, that's shocking. That punch must have had a lot of power on it. That looked almost like a jab.
Whew. He says he's all right. Oh, and Rojas quickly on his man. Rojas driving him to the ropes and throwing punches. Pompey trying to fight him off and fighting back. Throws a pretty good right hand of his own.
You know, it's not that Pompey isn't counterpunching well. Boy, Albert Rojas, what dogged determination. He's walking through some big shots to get to Kevin Pompey.
Pompey trying to cover up and land a few of his own. Trying to shake the cobwebs. And
he is way... Those left hooks by Pompey are finding their mark. Rojas walking right through those punches now.
This is only round two. Pompey down and trying to fight his way out of that predicament.
I'll tell you what, you look at our card sometimes, you think, well, maybe this week we won't get a barn burner. Every week we've had one of these, and now we're getting another one.
Pompey fighting back quite well after that truly surprising knockdown.
What's interesting to me is Rojas is landing other punches that look much bigger than the knockout punch.
Yes.
And that knockout punch really hurt, or knockdown punch, hurt Kevin Pompey. And it wasn't just a flash knockdown.
Oh, no. He got against the ropes and...
But you know what's odd here now? Pompey's probably winning the rest of this round.
He's landing some awfully solid shots. And he, I don't know, it may be ridiculous to say, but that knockdown really woke him up. It appears to, there's a solid right. They stand there toe-to-toe and exchange them.
You know what, though? Rojas is taking those punches from Pompey a little bit better than Kevin is taking the bombs from Rojas right now.
A little heavy hitter. Heavier hitter, I should say. Rojas, Alfredo.
Pompey is really putting some beautiful combinations together. Landing hooks, overhand right, and Rojas is just ignoring it. What a round.
Boy, indeed, what a round. Toe-to-toe, and the crowd here at the Showboat loved every moment of it.
Left hook, and you were off balance.
Rojas, six knockouts.
Okay, pal? All right, pal. All right. Give me the time. All right?
Mm-hmm. You ready?
Wait a minute. You all right?
Yes.
All right.
We'll get a chance to see the knockdown. Well, it was a good right before, and that's as stiff a jab as you're going to get hit with. And it was a jab, by golly.
Bang.
Interesting. I think part of it was he was off balance. But I think the punch definitely stunned him.
Rojas has only knocked out six of his 14 wins. He's had six knockouts out of the 14 victories.
Kevin Pompey did come back in that round and landed some big shots. Good body work there by Kevin. And he landed some major league punches toward the end of that round.
All right, here we go with round number three. This is scheduled for eight. Kevin Pompey in the gray trunks. In the red, Alfredo Rojas.
Interesting statistic from our Old Spice punch profile people, Bob Kenobi and Logan Hobson. 83 power punches landed in that last round between the two men. That would be anything that wasn't a jab, it was a big power punch. That's a lot.
Pompey now bobbing and weaving, trying to stay away from the thunder that Rojas has shown that he possesses. He'll work his way in, start with the left, follow the right. Rojas walked right through some very substantial blows in that second round. Pompey going to put the boxing shoes on, would appear. Jab and go and move. Gave Pompey the first round and Rojas the second.
Yeah, and the reason I did not make it a 10-8 round for Rojas despite the knockdown is I thought Pompey came back to win almost the rest of that round, even though Rojas did some good work, so I didn't make it a 10-8 round.
Kevin Pompey in the gray and Alfredo Rojas in red, scheduled for 8 at 140, call it 147 pounds. Pompey went down, a right hand, and then a stiff, jolting left, decked it in round 2. We're in the third round. Both fighters very busy. Pompey with the left hand.
Kevin Pompey is really wicked with those left hooks to the body and the head. I give Rojas all the credit in the world. This 27-year-old has really taken some shots from Pompey. Kevin is not a devastating puncher, but he's got some power. And
he too has scored 6 knockouts like Rojas in his career. He's 11-2 with that draw as he comes into this fight tonight. I tell you, Rojas is really tough to discourage him. He's got Pompey against the ropes, throwing punches and bunches. Not all of them landing. Takes another left hand, slows him down for a second.
Do you believe Rojas is in there on almost a year layoff? Hasn't fought since last March. Look how sharp he's looking.
Yeah. Indeed, it'd be interesting to see in what shape he is to go the 8 rounds if indeed this fight continues into the late stages here. This is only round number 3. And it's been a busy third round like the 2 preceding it. Well, we'll be back to see what number 4 brings after this message.
Rojas landing this good straight right hand to the head of Kevin Pompey. Now, that didn't knock him down, and the jab did. Go figure that one out.
We're in round number 4. It's scheduled for 8. Pompey in the gray trunks, Alfredo Rojas in red. As Al told you, Pompey was down, right hand followed by a very stiff short and to the point jab knocked him flat.
Look at that. First of all, the numbers of punches staggering, and then the percentage that Pompey is landing is amazing.
Good solid left hand again by Pompey. Set a spray of moisture, perspiration, and what have you from the head of Alfredo Rojas, who has not fought since back in 1988. His last bout was in March, so we're talking a year and 3 months since he was last in the ring. Interesting to see what kind of endurance Rojas has. We're at the Showboat Hotel in Atlantic City. These two young men here, that's Kevin Pompey in the gray and Alfredo Rojas in red. 147 pounders. Pompey down in the second round. He's moving quite well, though, Al, and he seems to be the sharper puncher of the two right now. I didn't say heavier hitter, just the sharper puncher of the two.
He's showing a little more foot movement to Rojas than he did earlier. I want to take this opportunity to congratulate you, Mr. Kelly. You are a grandfather.
I am indeed, yes.
How could a guy so young and dapper and handsome as you be a grandfather?
America is a wonderful country. just tremendous.
Congratulations. That's nice for you.
Sean Christopher Owen Kelly.
All right.
8'6". And Grandpa's doing quite well.
You seem to be holding him quite well.
Yes, I am. We don't have pictures. My good friends in the truck, the best production group in the world, wanted a picture. Had I but known, gentlemen, I would have brought the whole collage. I forgot to.
Send it to us some week even when you're not here,
yes,
Tom.
Maybe
we'll show it.
When we meet again, I'll have pictures of me holding up.
I like that.
Well, he's a handsome youngster. Of course, his mother's beautiful.
That helps,
well,
doesn't it?
Big part of the battle, no question.
Pompey's been missing a lot in this round, throwing more punches than he was earlier, but missing quite a bit. Not that one, though.
No. I tell you, Rojas, he blinked, huh?
But he didn't go anywhere. He's got a chin.
Oh, boy, doesn't he? This is round four. And you can see the seconds drifting away here. Been a very busy round for Pompey, who has done most of the fighting here in this round. Rojas maybe showing the effects of over a year layoff. We don't know. We'll wait to see how that develops. And there's the bell, and Rojas lands one at the end of the bell. We'll be back.
Kevin Pompey, this was that right toward the end of the last round. Now, Rojas did not move. He's getting hit with these shots, and he is not going anywhere. But I think you made a very cogent comment right at the end of that round. He's starting to really slow down, and that your layoff may have an impact.
Well, we'll see what effect it does have. You're looking at Kevin Pompey, who is down in the second round from as stiff a straight left as you'll see, and he seems to have weathered that. And now as we go into round number five, and it's scheduled for eight, bear in mind that Pompey has not fought since January, although Rojas, his counterpart, has not fought since March of 88. Indeed, the layoff is something. Boxing is such an enervating sport. I don't know that there's anything quite so enervating to just drain the juices and the vitality from a man. Anybody who can get in that ring and go for any distance, any. Pompey ahead by two on Al Bernstein's scorecard.
Gave him the last round, and even though his percentage level went down, way down, he threw 64 punches and only landed 17, 27% as opposed to 56% that he had earlier in the bout, but he still landed more punches than Rojas.
To continue my thought about how enervating this sport is, while you can do all the gym work you want, you've got to do a lot of it. But the minute you climb into the ring for real, the strength just seems to run right out of your shoes.
That's really true, Tom. It's all different. Yeah. I think anybody that's ever boxed at all, even on an amateur level or anything, can never forget the first time you step into a ring and you see a guy in front of you, and it's just the two of you, and this time you really mean it. You're not sparring, you mean it.
No headgear, and
yeah,
it's for real.
Rojas with a good double left hook.
But Pompey is moving quite well. He's in and out. A lot of lateral movement. Working with the left hand. Follows with the right. Comes back with another left. Another right. Unanswered. And Rojas looks to be just a tad slower than he was in the first two or three rounds, Al Bernstein.
Yeah, Pompey is giving him a little bit more lateral movement, making it tougher for him to land those shots. For Rojas, that is.
Pompey went down in the second. He has really laid some thunderous blows on Rojas, who has a very solid chin, and there's a solid exchange. Once Pompey gets in and wants to stand toe-to-toe, Rojas is more than anxious to meet him there. Good right hand by Rojas, and he hurt Pompey. He's got him against the ropes. That right hand hurt Pompey. Rojas, sensing that Pompey's in trouble, is all over him, but Pompey throws a couple of lefts to keep him off.
When Pompey is hurt on this ropes, he counterpunches well. It's amazing. And Rojas just wails away.
Good solid right hand by Pompey with his back against the ropes and a pretty good left. Closing down round five in grand style, Pompey and Rojas. They're off the ropes now, and we'll be back to see about round number.
Well, this right hand by Rojas stunned Pompey, sent him back, but off the ropes, Pompey counterpunching extremely well.
All of which brings us to live action again. Round six, Showboat Hotel and Casino. The Boardwalk's Big Easy here in Atlantic City. I'm Tom Kelly with boxing's foremost ringside analyst, Al Bernstein. We mentioned earlier, I'll mention it again, to be honored at the banquet in New York this week. I think that's tremendous.
Well, thank you. It should be fun. I'm looking forward to it.
In the fifth round, this is what the punch profile machine turned up.
So the Pompey landing more, even though he was driven back against ropes and hurt by Rojas.
Well, he had much the best of it, I think, Al, in the first 2 minutes of that round.
Yeah.
Then got hit and was hurt, but had enough to land a big right we showed you of his own. So It's, I don't know how the judges saw it.
Well, you know, this, what this fight boils down to is that Rojas is able to hurt Pompey a little bit more than Pompey can hurt Rojas. But in terms of punches landed, which I think is the ultimate test of who's going to win any fight, you know, I think you have to go with Pompey.
Rojas does appear to hit a lot harder. Pompey keeps chopping that left hand. He's landed some solid right hand leads as well. We haven't seen a lot of guys working to the body here in this fight. And the minute I said it, then Rojas threw two or three to the midsection. But there hasn't been a lot of work to the body.
Kevin Pompey just keeps bouncing those left hooks off Rojas' head. Now, part of the problem is, when Kevin, like so many other boxers, when Kevin throws his left to the body, he gets very good leverage into it. Sometimes when he throws it to the head, he doesn't get as good leverage, and he makes it a little bit more of an arm punch. Good example, even champions have that problem. Even if somebody as skilled as, let's say, a Michael Nunn, who we've seen many times, and he throws his hook to the body, he has great leverage to the head. Sometimes he slaps with it.
Rojas gives you the feeling of being very dangerous when they get in close and stand toe-to-toe. Seems to be a heavier hitter. Pompey hits him a lot of times, snapping his head back with that left hand. Rojas is tough indeed. Neither one noted as a knockout guy. Each has six knockouts in their careers today. Out of 14 wins for Rojas, out of 11 wins for Pompey. 50%, I mean, or thereabouts, give or take a blow one way or the other. It's not bad, but...
Yeah, I think what's interesting is here are two boxers who are not well-known. We've had Pompey on a couple of times. Rojas is new to us. Middle-of-the-road journeyman kind of guys who, you know what, they're not bad.
Indeed.
They are not bad fighters.
And they have really pleased this crowd with their performance so far. Round six is coming to a close. A moment ago, Pompey with a solid right. And now the round comes to a close. We'll be back.
Only one punch. I want you to throw them combinations. Like we walk in the gym, okay? We do it this round, please.
All right.
Okay? Come on.
They want combinations. One left hook. Now he's going to go back to the left hook again. The right hand followed. And, well, he did throw a left hook later, I'm sure. I'm sure sometime later in that round he threw a left hook.
Round seven, it's scheduled for eight. At 147 pounds, give or take an ounce or two either way. Right hand lead by Pompey. Rojas is in the red trunks. Fighting out of New York City. He was from South America. Nice left-right combination as instructions by Pompey. Both scored. Pompey was down in the second round. A right hand and then a solid left jab put him to the deck. Left hand of Rojas stung Pompey, caused him to bite right down on that mouthpiece as if to say, why did I get hit with that? Pompey bouncing, moving, lateral, in and out. 59-55, he has Pompey ahead by 4 points despite, well, he didn't. Bear in mind now, he did not give Rojas a 10-8 round in
That's
the second
right.
round
Which
because Pompey was doing very well. So make that a 10-9 round if you're going along with Al scoring on it.
But it could be a 10-8 round, yeah. So it wouldn't be surprising or inappropriate for the judges to have a 10-8. And several of those other rounds were close, but I just feel Pompey's landed a lot more punches.
Rojas stepping it up just a notch here, throwing some bombs out there, just trying to walk right through Pompey. There's a good left by Pompey, but Rojas trying to walk right through his man.
Alfredo Rojas wants this fight. You can see it in this round. I mean, he wants this fight badly. And even though with the year layoff, maybe a little fatigue, even with a guy in front of him who's fighting a very good technical fight, Rojas trying to take it from him.
Either man is marked. Noticeably, that is, despite the fact that Pompey was down in the second. There's a bit of puffiness under the eyes, of course. The cheeks are swollen a bit. Solid right hand by Pompey. For just a moment, Rojas blinked, but only for a moment. There's a left by Pompey. Rojas short with a right and a left, and Pompey misses with a hook. Buries one to the body. Right hand, right hand. This is round seven. moving forward. Rojas more than willing to mix it up. They exchange low lefts.
And there's an example of how Pompey gets leverage into that body punch. Alfredo Rojas has had a very good round here. So has Pompey for that matter. But Rojas landed a big shot.
Nice flurries, nice combinations. Again, Pompey with a solid left, right. That's the end of round number 7. We're back into the corner with Alfredo Rojas. Spanish, of course, is the language in that corner. Did I hear importante? Very important. It probably is. Round 8 coming up. He had Pompey down in the second round. Been an amazing performance by that man who hasn't been in the ring in 15 months.
You gotta take this one good, but make a miss.
Okay. You double up on that jab now. You've got to work. You got to hustle this round out.
This is the last one. This is a
crucial round. Very, very close. Okay, you know, he comes running at you onto them things. You just spin out of them.
They asked Kevin Pompey for combinations before this round. He is trying to do what they want. Now, he landed 2 out of those 3, both slapping punches, but they did land.
Like all 3 of them were slappers, really. That right hand was really just kind of a cuffing punch. This is round number 8. Pompey was down in the second round. Rojas in red, Pompey in gray. Through 7 rounds, Rojas has thrown 160 more punches than Pompey and landed, I'm going to tell you, 70 less. Percentage favors Pompey. Those thrown, those landed, 56% of the blows. Of course, the optimum would be to throw 100 and land 100, but have you got a rule of thumb in there as to how many thrown and what kind of, is 56 a good percentage?
Oh, yeah, I think, and you know what we ought to do one day? We ought to get both Logan Hobson and Bob Canobio on our show and talk about the percentages, because they have all kinds of figures on what percentages are good and bad. If you can get 50%, I'm sure that's considered outstanding.
Solid right hand lead by Pompey, who's forcing the action here. Another left hand for Pompey. Combinations, but with more slaps than solid short 2-point jolting shots. That left hand is pretty good. Rojas had Pompey down in the second. He's a man cut.
The man that knocked Rojas down out, Dexter Smith in Miami, he had to hit him with a baseball bat, I think.
I'm sure.
Pompey just landed a thunderous right hand. Rojas did not back up at all. It'd be frustrating.
Again, a solid right hand by Pompey.
Nothing. Doesn't even move Rojas.
No.
Again. Pompey is not a devastating right-hand puncher. He has more power in his left hook, but still should have more of an impact on Rojas than it does.
You would think at this stage of the fight, there's been 8 grueling rounds, and by now, one of those right hands would really cause you to blink, if not take 2 backward steps. But
yeah.
Now these, Rojas is throwing a lot of leather, but doing nothing with it. Quite
not
much.
Really landing. I'll tell you what, this might be a fight that maybe 5 months from now, people have a hard time remembering exactly who fought in it. Let me tell you, this is an outstanding battle. 2 terrific young fighters.
Boy, I tell you, Pompey hit Rojas with some kind of shots, and I dare say if you talk to Kevin Pompey and you say, Victor Davis and Alfredo Rojas, tough, he's going to say, tough.
Yeah.
Let me tell you what tough is.
Oh, very boy. Nice performance by both these
That's
young men.
Right.
Alfredo Rojas, after a year layoff, give him all the credit in the world. He was certainly a lot sharper than you would anticipate him being. He has a terrific chin. Also landed some very big shots, one of which actually knocked Pompey down.
That's right. In the second round, Not only did he land some big shots, went eight rounds, and they were not waltzing around again, Matilda. They were very busy, full of punches rounds that really belied the fact that this man has been off for a year and a half. Pompey hasn't fought since June when he fractured a small bone in his hand, but he said it's healed completely. Look at that. 1,222 punches.
They were busy. They were busy.
Wow.
And look at the connect percentage from Pompey. 53%, a very good percentage, way above the norm. And, of course, a low percentage for Rojas, though he landed some big power shots.
So Rojas has the tape cut off. Michael Buffer has the cards from the officials. Let's find out who won.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is the official scoring. Frank J. Burnett scores about 76-75. Eugene Grant has it 78-73. And Frank J. Cairo scores it 78-74 for the winner by unanimous decision, Kevin Pompey.
Very tough fight. Kevin Pompey winning it. 76-75, 78-73, 78-74. We'll be back to find out how he felt about it right after this. Tough fight. Win for Pompey. Al Bernstein's with the winner.
Well, Kevin Pompey, you don't get anybody easy, it doesn't seem. Whoever they put you in against, he's tough. Rojas with a terrific chin and hit you with some good shots. First, what about that jab he knocked you down with? That was a strong punch.
That was a jab?
Yeah, believe it or not, it was a jab.
Wow. Oh, wow. Well, it felt like steel, I tell you that.
I bet it did.
Yeah, but I was going backwards.
Yeah.
At the same time. But I'll tell you, sure, it did hurt.
What about, now you did a wonderful job of mixing in those left hooks to the body and the head. Is that something you came in with? And also, a few right hands. Let's take a look at a right hand that you landed on Rojas.
Oh, yeah. Geez, he does have a strong. But, what you said about the left hooks and, you know, working to the body, coming to the head, Tony works very strong with me with that. And if it didn't come out today, I need to quit because he works so hard with me with those.
All right, very quickly, what do you see in the near future for yourself? Contender pretty soon, hopefully?
You got to ask my manager about that.
All right, well, congratulations. Good win.
All right, thank you.
So he is a winner again, Kevin Pompey. He wanted a big win. He got it. We'll be back with more on Top Rank Boxing.